Let's take a look at this interesting post on Reddit. OP wants to create an array of openings on this watering can attachment. In order for this attachment to work as intended, we need each and every one of these openings to point towards the center, assuming that this surface is spherical. I'm going to start with this body here. This was created by shredding a sphere and splitting off the top. For the first half of this video, I'll be talking about problems with using the emboss command. If you're not interested in that, feel free to skip to the proposed solution using the timestamp. Since there was an update recently that allowed for embossing to be done on a spherical face, I thought that it might be a good idea to try that. Let's start by embossing a single circle. This is simply a sketch circle drawn on an offset plane. Go to Create, Emboss. Select the circle as the profile. For faces, click on the select box and select the spherical face. Adjust the distance to cut through the thickness. If you perform a cross section, we can see that the inside face of the hole is actually conical. This is because the emboss command is attempting to wrap the circular profile onto the spherical face. Just keep this in mind when trying to emboss circular profiles. Next, let's try creating a rectangular pattern of this emboss feature. Is the rectangular pattern command smart enough to recognize our design intent and adjust the pattern instances according to the curvature? Let's find out. Begin the rectangular pattern. Set object type to features and select the embossed cut. For axis, click on the select box and select the x-axis or the z-axis. Set distribution type to spacing. Set the direction to symmetric for both axes. Adjust the quantity and spacing. I will just do a limited pattern just to see what happens. At first glance, it looks pretty good. But if we do a cross section, we can see that the axes of the holes do not adjust according to the curvature. Indeed, the cross-section of the holes seem pretty random. Instead of patterning features, let's try patterning a sketch instead. I prepared beforehand a rectangular array of sketch circles. This was done by using the rectangular pattern within the sketch environment. Begin the emboss command. Box select all circles as the profiles. And select the spherical face as the face. In this case, an error appears. To me, this does not seem like a particularly challenging scenario. The circles are still well within the spherical face. Let's remove the profiles and try selecting less circles. This time round, it does work. But the openings look distorted. So it seems like embossing does not work. Do try this out and let me know your results. Perhaps I'm doing something wrong here. Next, I attempted to use a circular pattern. Begin by using the sketch circle to create a simple extrude. Since this is centered on the origin, we know that this will point towards the center. As this is a simple extrude, we also know that the side walls will be perfectly cylindrical. Begin a circular pattern. Set object type to feature and select the extruder cut. For axis, click on the select box and select the x-axis in this case. Set distribution to symmetric. Adjust the angle and quantity. From here, you can create a circular pattern of this pattern. For the feature, you need to select both the original extrude and the pattern. Select the Z-axis as the axis in this case. Set distribution to symmetric. Adjust the angle and quantity. If we look at the cross section, we can see that the holes all point towards the center. So at this point, many of you would point out that this does not really create openings that are equally spaced. Indeed, if you were to perform this workflow on a more extended spherical face, you will start to see openings bunching up at the extreme ends. In the case of this watering can attachment, we are patterning on a relatively small portion of the sphere, so the holes still look reasonably spaced. We can clean these three holes up by simply selecting these faces and deleting them using the delete key. Just make sure that you do that while the solid tab is active.